You know, I love reading Paul's letters to the church because these are letters that are written by Paul, but the Holy Spirit has tagged his heart, has told him to write this way. God ordained him when he saved him on the road to Damascus. It's absolutely amazing. And it's the same thing that happened with John. Although John saw Jesus Christ after his resurrection and after he's at the right hand of the Father and in heaven, and when he was coming back, as well as before. So John has the best perspective of seeing Jesus Christ in these different states. However, we don't know what Paul did or didn't do in terms of understanding God. But we know from 1 Corinthians, well, actually 2 Corinthians chapter 13, that he had a lot to think about when it came to Jesus Christ. Listen to what he writes in chapter 6, verse 11. He says, "See with what large letters I am writing to you, with my own hand." So God is not unwilling to use Paul. God is willing to use Paul to communicate his message. Take your Bible guide and turn that to today. And we're going to study this, Galatians chapter 6. It is amazing. And as we study it, may God teach us and show us what it is that he is telling us today. If you don't have your Bible guide, write to the address at the bottom of the screen and send us a letter and say, "I need the Bible guide." We'd be happy to send it to you. Or go to www.BibleDiscoveryTV.com. BibleDiscoveryTV.com. Don't forget the TV, very important. And click on donate, make a donation in any amount. Now, as we move in this direction, we begin to understand a few things. What does real faith look like? I know there's faith, and there's unique faith in different religions, but what is faith in Jesus Christ supposed to look like? Now, that's important because we hear people are labeled with things today. Everybody wants to label them. But what does it mean to be a Christian, to be somebody who follows Christ? We read Galatians 5 and 6, looking at Galatians 6, 1 to 10. Father, I pray today in the name of Jesus Christ that you would help us to understand what you're saying. Thank you, Lord, and help us, Holy Spirit, to hear you today in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Look at the first scripture. This is very important. It says in Galatians 6, verse 1, it says, "Brethren," he's talking to the people, the brothers of himself in Jesus Christ. He says, "Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass," in any sin, "trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness." Restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself least, lest you also be tempted. You know, this is amazing because as we see this, we understand that God is talking to us. We must face our personal life with forgiveness and not with judgment. We don't judge people. That's God's job. It's a good thing we don't, because we would be judged. This is how God faced sinners while on earth. You see, it's not everybody is perfect. When we come to Jesus Christ, we give him our life. And the process of sanctification takes over and begins to get a hold of us. But occasionally, there is a temptation in our life that overcomes us. And when we see somebody who's tempted or failing, we don't need to judge them and stand back and say they're doing this. We need to go and help them as they love Jesus Christ. We need to help them get out of that. Very important, beloved. We need to consider that. Now let's go on to Galatians 6, verse 2. It says, "Bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ." The law of Christ? Are you serious? Exactly. Bear one another's burdens and fulfill the law of Christ. In other words, help each other. Learn. For if anyone thinks himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceives himself. But let each one examine his own work. His own work. And then he will have rejoicing in himself alone and not in another. Verse 5, "For each one shall bear his own load." You know, the responsibility of following Jesus Christ is huge. We must beware of pride and help each other fulfill the law of Christ. It's huge because we have to constantly come back and say, Lord Jesus, I failed. Help me not to fail again. We must realize that all of us are sinners, beloved. Every single person on earth is a sinner. We come to Christ and Christ himself comes into our life as we make him Lord of our life. He takes over. This is so important. So many people today, I mean, they don't look at Christianity this way, but that's how Christianity is presented in the Bible, in the Word of God. In fact, let's continue on in this passage. It says in chapter 6, verse 6, let him who is taught the word, that's the word of God, share in all good things with him who teaches. What? Absolutely. Do not be deceived, he says. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will reap. He's kind of talking about giving to the ministry here. For he who sows to his flesh will of the flesh reap corruption. But he who sows to the Spirit of the Spirit reaps everlasting life. And let us not grow weary while doing good. For in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us so do good to all, especially those who are of the household of faith. He calls the Christian belief system a household. You see, beloved, we must never grow tired of doing right and doing good. Now, Paul speaks that. And he says, you need to share with the one who teaches. The people of faith in Jesus Christ are called the household of faith. Beloved, when we understand and when we realize what's happening here, we have to get it that God speaks to us today. And if somebody teaches and we are blessed by such a teaching, we should give to that person. We should help that person. I mean, whatever God tells you, that's the important thing, beloved. And I think that, people through the years have gotten weird. And they say, well, if you give this amount, then this will happen. Look, I know God will bless you. And I know God will give back to you because I also give. But it's important for us to recognize that we must give personally according to what God says, according to what the Lord teaches, beloved. So as we do that, and as we think that through, and as we understand that, then we become people who are of the household of faith, who have grown in Christ. You see, we don't come to Christ and that's it. No, God gives us the Holy Spirit so we can learn His Word primarily. Very important, beloved, as we consider what God has said in chapter 6. Let's remember the Holy Spirit helps us. Think you can read the Bible in 1 year? Click the Bible Guide links and make a donation in any amount. Start your daily devotional today.